See, when I was an NDA cadet way back in the early 80s, at that point of time when I wanted to study butterflies, there was no book available to study Indian butterflies. You could get books on butterflies about European butterflies. And the only two books which were available to guide any serious enthusiast were both out of print. One was a book written in the early 1950s by Colonel M.A. Winter Blythe.
Mm-hmm.
Which was published by the BNHS, and another one even much earlier than that, written in 1932 by Brigadier W.H. Evans of the Indian Army retired, which was basically a sort of a checklist and a key to how to identify butterflies. Now with these two resources, with black and white photographs, or you need to borrow it from a friend and all, it was very very difficult to identify and learn about butterflies, yet we struggled and persisted and all. Today it is very easy for people to know about
the available resources.
But when I started in 2006, at that time there were no page on Indian butterflies.
Mm-hmm.
There. So between myself, Viren Vaz, Shyamal, and to extent Vijay Barve also,
yeah,
we began those checklists and those pages and those articles and put them up. They are still not complete. Task is a long way to go.
Mm-hmm.
But at least there is a decent amount of material on Indian butterflies,
yeah,
which is there on the net, so that people can, if you want, they want something which is to at least look and identify Indian butterflies for.
Mm-hmm.
So that effect was really, really important, and that's what we try to, get into place. So that was one of my motivations, at that time, to create resources which I had always wanted and I could not get. I could never find anything which explains scales to me properly. So another article I wrote, that was my first good article, was snake scales. Now of course when I go back and look at it, I see how, it's immature or missing. It's still around, it's still a good article.
Yeah.
But today I'd write it differently, but it was a great labor of love for me at that point of time.
Mm-hmm.
Where I caught the snake myself, I took the photographs of the parts myself, I'd done the labeling using this with a paint.
Marker?
Paint.
Oh,
paint.
Okay.
Yes, paints.
In Windows.
Yeah.
Myself. And and then created that article.
Mm-hmm.
Another one was external morphology of the Lepidoptera. That is about,
mm-hmm,
the external parts,
yeah,
of the butterflies and things about it. So I needed to learn about it. So I wanted something more technical. Now,
mm-hmm,
none of the books which are guided, this thing goes into any kind of depth about the biology of butterflies. So,
yeah.
So, and whatever was there was not coming up fast enough, or was not there. There was no wiki project on Lepidoptera.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, that was the wiki project which I started. So, I can say that is another thing which I am proud of. So, I started,
mm-hmm,
a real life wiki project Lepidoptera. It's fairly okay. It's a small wiki project. There aren't too many people doing too many things,
mm-hmm,
but it just keeps ticking along and going along. And once in a while, someone active comes and keeps working hard. And quite a lot of quiet people working hard in their own way. So
yeah,
I'm happy that so took place. So basically, my motivation has always been to do something which I tried something. I felt that I needed it.
Mm-hmm.
Now I got a chance. I should do that.
Yeah, and to bring out things which are not there. Which are not available.
Yeah, now later on my focus changed, and
mm-hmm,
afterwards I went on to another higher level of play, where,
sure,
I found that I wanted to, whatever skills I learned, I wanted to teach it to others. And
sure,
I wanted to, so then I got involved mostly in outreach and in teaching skills, Wikipedia skills and that kind of thing, and mentoring young people. And at the same time I took up a volunteer work on Wiki Project India,
mm-hmm,
and meet with
Would you like to?
All I did was just being there, talk to some people, and there is somebody to talk around who is reliably there, and all of a sudden the project was active once again. It's not that I did something to see, but just by being there and pulling some and posting some things here and there and all,
sure,
the project just a certain amount of active brought the project back into center stage.
Yeah.
Of course, there are some foreigners who are there, and there are some people who have these views, and there are some people who are maha unhappy,
mm-hmm,
because they don't get what they want. But Wikipedia, Project India, India Notice Board is going great guns, I feel.
And would you like to share some experience with the Tags and Assets project?
The Tag and Assets project, I feel really happy, is because it shows how our community has matured.
Mm-hmm.
When it began as an outcome of a... In Wiki conference, I was asked to give the state of English Wikipedia along that. And when I saw the state of English Wikipedia, it was a series of disastrous numbers. It was like all our HR indexes of our country are bad that way. Of India, we have got tons and so many percent articles are in bad shape and so many are unassessed and all sort of thing. So people thought I am the real doomsday slayer. But one thing out of that was greater awareness. And soon I found that people were actually willing to address the issue once they found Wiki Project India becoming active. And at that point of time, we found that once we started these things and started small activities like our monthly article improvement program, which Pratik
Lahoti
was looking after, and then people coming in and working, and lot of other people, Rangilo Gujarati and someone here, and editors, experienced editors, young editors, everyone coming and going through. Then suddenly that came is that why don't we pick up this thing once again, because a previous couple of years ago Tag and Assets had been done.
Yeah.
So I'm forgetting the exact people who are involved because I don't remember things so well nowadays. But when this was meditative, so I did the thing which I needed was first is I drew up the framework.
Yeah.
And I made up that framework and I put it aside, and then people started working. At first everyone was working only manually. Then in I think it was February last
UV year Panda
I had a chance to meet UV Panda and gang, because they came to Pune for the
Gnunify
festival at SICSR. And that's when I asked Srik.lak, I said, I need help in this, who can do this for me? So he says, there's UV Panda, go and trouble him. So I met UV Panda for the first time. And he said, yeah, that he was interested in doing that, and he, over a period of time, he cobbled up a prototype and we tested it out, and even now it is not maybe such a strong and thing and all, it's not industrial strength, but it's a fairly good working software, and it has really helped a large amount of us to carry out the assessment, and the complete assessment drive has succeeded because people have used UV Panda's Tag and Assess software more than maybe the other Autobots which were there for bot related assisted operations. So now what happened is that after I'd done this and all of a sudden a lot of people became interested, and when we put up that list for some awards and activities and all, a whole new people set of people came self-motivated and you know, started assessing, and they started taking areas under their interest, and some of them started bringing more recruits,
subcategories,
and then some people started you know, assuming responsibilities on their own, and before I knew it, I didn't need to do anything much. I was just had to stand back and relax and watch everyone doing everything. So it was like, you know, you just put a put a crystal, and then you know, see that, you know, that out of that in a concentrated solution, you just put a seed crystal, and all of a sudden, tuck, you get a, so that was it.
Or
yes, one more thing I did do was that I wrote some three primers, two or three primers articles on how to assess, and all the details about the Wiki project, the assessment program, and the format of the template, and all that sort of thing. So that people could address that. So, but that's basically what I've done. I have not done any assessment work, anything. I'm not even sure whether I got the minimum award. But that gave me great happiness, because all of a sudden, from being sub 1 lakh, we went to well over 1 lakh. And a lot of people came up, and the whole thing was being driven by people whom I didn't even know or had not met. And it seemed to give an avenue for fresh talent to appear and do things with them. Why India, even Wiki Project Pakistan of its own finally got a tag and access, and even someone tried to start it in America and other places and all. So there were, you know, sort of second order and third order effects also. So, so that gave me great happiness. So I think I was genuinely happiest about that diagnosis.
Thanks a lot, Ashwin. Now you're here in Calcutta, and now the community would be needing your help again. So
I'm always there. And I'm part of the community. So I'm sure that in Kolkata we will do some interesting things in the future to come.
Sure. Thanks a lot, Ashwin, for your time.